The Pennsylvania House of Representatives usually opens its session with a prayer. But unfortunately, since the first Muslim woman has been sworn in as a member of the House in Pennsylvania, it appears that some of the Republican members of the House have weaponized that prayer in order to send a message. So what you're about to watch is the Republican representative, her name is Stephanie Borowicz. And here she is praying, and you can clearly see that she's trying to send a message. Take a look.
Jesus, I thank you for this privilege, Lord, of letting me pray, God, that I, Jesus, am your ambassador here today, standing here representing you, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the great I am, the one who's coming back again, the one who came, died, and rose again on the third day.
Okay, I'm gonna have a controversial opinion on this, although when don't I? But I'm amused by her shenanigans. Others are not, they're very angry. But I'm like, yeah, keep on going. Ben-Hur, Zeus of Zeuses.
Okay, so this
Uhtred, son of Uhtred. Keep going, who cares?
All right, so a little tippy tip of the iceberg. There's more, let's take a look.
We ask that we not be overcome by evil and that we overcome evil with good in this land once again. I claim all these things in the powerful, mighty name of Jesus, the one who at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess, Jesus, that you are Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Now look, it's a serious thing, and that's why the guy comes up at the end like, are you gonna wrap this thing up? Because the prayer is supposed to just be a quick prayer, bring everyone together, and it's not supposed to be propaganda. And it's not an accident that she did this on the first day that the Muslim American woman is right in the house. And so she's trying to rub it in like, the Muslims are not gonna rule us, okay? Jesus is the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, and he's the only one, you will bow down.
So I think the relevant video is the one that we're about to go to next. But first, let me give you more information on the Muslim representative who was just sworn in. Her name is Movita Johnson Harrell, and she's a Democrat. She's a Muslim, and the first Muslim who has been sworn in the House of Representatives in Pennsylvania. And so you're right in that they usually do open the session with a prayer, but it's not divisive. It's usually quick and it's not as aggressive. I mean, she's pretty aggressive in this prayer, which is kind of, I have to be honest, it's entertaining to watch, right? But I get that people are upset. Let's quickly go to the next video and then we'll talk about it.
God, for those that came before us like George Washington and Valley Forge and Abraham Lincoln who sought after you in Gettysburg, Jesus, and the founding fathers in Independence Hall, Jesus, that sought after you and fasted and prayed for this nation to be founded on your principles and your words and your truths. God, forgive us. Jesus, we've lost sight of you. We've forgotten you, God, in our country. And we're asking you to forgive us, Jesus, that your promise and your word says that if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from their wicked ways, that you'll heal our land. Jesus, you are our only hope.
It went on and on and on. So
then the guy, I like the guy next to her who at one point was like, is this thing ever gonna be over?
Yeah.
And so by the way, of course, she is unsurprisingly historically incorrect as well. A lot of the founding fathers were not Christians. They were theists, Thomas Jefferson famously shredded the Bible, literally. He's like, yeah, this part makes no sense, and he would rip it out, okay? Mm-hmm. This page also makes no sense, I'm ripping it out. So the Jefferson Bible only had the good parts. So this whole thing, oh yeah, the founding fathers without Jesus couldn't have done anything, that's why they founded the country without Jesus. Except they didn't, they wrote in the Constitution, don't establish a religion. I think you might have missed that part, that part's pretty important.
Okay, so weaponizing the prayer and weaponizing religion, just to make a point about how much you dislike the new Muslim representative that got elected into office, is not okay, not very Christian-like. I feel like it's just not a kind, nice thing to do. But okay, so she decided to go in that direction. But what I don't understand is in politics, right, we're talking about the government. These are people who are paid through taxpayer money. They continuously endorse a specific religion over and over again. And everybody turns, you know, a blind eye to it and they think it's not that big of a deal. Who cares? Just let them open with a prayer. But this is what happens, right? Like, you're not supposed to have government, push one particular religion And that's exactly what happens in our government all the time. And so, look, I wouldn't have been, I guess, offended by that, even though it was meant to be offensive, but I would be annoyed by it. Because like, what are we doing? Like, we're spending all this time listening to your like weird panicky prayer about how we've lost our way. Like, we got stuff to do. Let's go.
Yeah, and look, I get why people are offended. Don't get us wrong. When she's like, Jesus, save us because we've lost our way. Meaning like, if there's ever a Muslim allowed into any legislative chamber in the country, that means, well, we're lost. The country is lost. I mean, look, let's just be super clear about this. Stephanie Borowicz is deeply un-American. She's in a sense a traitor to the country, and more specifically to the United States Constitution. The Constitution is crystal clear. You are not allowed to establish a religion. You're not allowed to discriminate among the religions. But Borowicz doesn't believe that. She believes that her religion should rule all of us. That's why she's un-American. If she wants a country that's a theocracy, she should get the hell out of our country. She should move to Saudi Arabia or Iran or maybe the Vatican. I don't know what strand of Christianity she is, and I don't care, but she should go form that theocracy somewhere else, because that's not what America is. So stop being against the country.
So Jordan Harris, who is the House Minority Whip in Pennsylvania, says the following: let me be clear, I am a Christian. I spend my Sunday mornings in church worshiping and being thankful for all that I have. But in no way does that mean I would flaunt my religion at those who worship differently than I do. There is no room in our Capitol building for actions such as this, and it's incredibly disappointing that today's opening prayer was so divisive. I like that he put out that statement, because it's like, hey, yo, I'm a Christian too, right? But let's not be needlessly cruel and discriminatory toward this new member.
No, look, the good Christians have to stand up for their religion. Otherwise, we're forced to think that these fundamentalist evangelical right-wingers represent all of you guys, and they're maniacs. They're fundamentalists, they want Armageddon, and they believe that Jesus is gonna vacuum us up into the sky, and the planes are gonna crash, and the cars are gonna crash when Jesus comes, and all the Jews are gonna die, and so are the Muslims, and it's gonna be awesome, okay? Well, I think they're lunatics. So you say, hey, well, that's 25% of the country. And so, but they believe in the insane stuff. And so if you're a good Christian, which is also a huge portion of the country, well, stand up for Jesus's Sermon on the Mount. Stand up for the needy, the homeless, the poor, like Jesus told you to, and fight back and reclaim your religion from these monsters who, when they see someone from a different religion, flip out and oh, Jesus, everybody bow down. Everybody bow down to my Lord, my Lord. I mean, that kind of vanity is also frowned upon in the good parts of the Bible. Of course, I'm agnostic, so I think Jefferson was right. I think there's wonderful parts of the Bible, and you should keep those, and the rest is hilarious and dangerous. And by the way, I say that for all the religions. And part of the reason I'm not as offended is, look, I mean, all these religions, if you read their text, they're goofy, they're super goofy. And so when she's like Uhtred, son of Uhtred, and may the Lord of Light shine upon us, and then the night is dark and full of terrors, I'm like, okay, whatever. Okay, I mean, you do you. I don't really particularly care about your voodoo. I find it deeply amusing, right?
That's why I'm saying. I mean, if I'm at work, imagine starting every day of work with a prayer like that. Like, what are we doing? We got stuff to do. Like, let's move on.
Could you imagine? Like,
I can't.
Look, and the conservatives think that we think like they do. I got news for you. We definitely do not think like you. Okay, so we don't want to enforce our point of view on you guys. We just want a country like the one promised in the Constitution that allows for all points of view on not just politically, but also religiously. So I don't agree with the Muslims either. If the Muslims did likewise and they came out and they said
some aggressive
prayer.
Yeah,
they're like, and Allah is the only Allah, and he will defeat all other Allahs. I would be like, hey, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All right, whatever, dude. And Muhammad came and spoke to God on the mountain, and God told him that he should get all the chicks. I'd be like, All right, that's like your opinion, man. Thanks for watching this free clip of the Young Turks. Don't forget to become a TYT member today. For more exclusive content, join now at tyt.com/join.